We're on Kiddushin Parak Gimel, Mishnah Aleph. First Mishnah in the third chapter of Masechet Kiddushin. Mishnah says, Omer lechaveiro, a person tells his friend, Tzevek adesh li'isha plonit, go marry plonit for me. Meaning, go, you be my agent to marry her for me. Okay. V'halach v'kitcha latzmo. And the guy was like, oh, good idea. And he wanted to marry plonit for himself, and he married her. Mekudeshe. The second marriage is a marriage. Okay? Batanura says, Amina b'gamara, my b'halach. What does it mean b'halach? I went, shalach b'ramaot. He was sly. He was sneaky. Okay? And he didn't make him a shaliach. It teaches us to afagab to lo asal shaliach mitchila lekach. Even though he didn't make him, he didn't say, you are my agent. Ela sha'amar lo kadesh li ishaplan. He said to him, just marry this woman for me on my behalf. Im kinsha b'ala atzmo, if the guy did it on his own, karina b'shalach b'ramaot. He did it with ramaot, with slyness. And he's a cheater. So, and even if the guy said, if I make you a shliach, and the guy then went and married him on his own, that's certainly a sly, a dishonest person. But nonetheless, the second guy doesn't have to do the agency of the first guy. Furthermore, the guy says, here is this pair of socks. It's worth a pruta, and with this pair of socks, I will make you marry to me. The marriage will become effective after 30 days. Somebody else comes and marries her within the 30 days. She's married to the second one. Why? Because the first kiddushin is not chal, doesn't take effect until the end of the 30 days. Somebody comes in under the wire, the marriage, he is married to her, and then the second marriage, i.e. the first one, can't take effect. Bat Yisrael lakohen. Tochal bitruma. Actually, there's two gears. So if she was a Bat Yisrael who married a Kohen, she could eat truma, or the other way around. Bat Yisrael, the Bartuna has the version of Bat Kohen the Yisrael. In Bat Kohen, if she's a Bat Kohen, she need katcha la'achar shloshim yom, and the marriage only takes effect after 30 days. Kol otam shloshim yom tochal bitruma. Okay, all those 30 days, she'll eat truma. Shalom nivsala melacho bitruma at Beit Aviyah. Because she did not become pasul, meaning when I say when the person marries her la'achar shloshim yom, during those 30 days she's not married. The other way, v'im bat Yisrael la'kohen, if she's a bat Yisrael, she's married a kohen, lo tochal b'truma, she can't eat truma, shadayin eina eshet kohen, she's not an eshet kohen. So, but depending on your girsa, some had bat Yisrael la'kohen and some had bat kohen the Yisrael, the halacha is going to be different. Next case, the first guy marries her me'achshav u'la'achar shloshim yom. He says both things. You're married to me now and after 30 days. And then another person comes and marries her. Now, during the 30 days. So the problem is like this. We have a safek. Did he mean now? Or then did he change his mind and say, so in this case, the second one is she's married and not married. She's married misafek. So therefore, She has to be divorced from both of them. Ba Yisrael la Kohen, or Ba Kohen Yisrael, or Ba Kohen Yisrael. So in either case, if she's a Ba Kohen, Ba Yisrael is marrying a Kohen, maybe she's married, maybe she's not. Or Ba Kohen Yisrael, lo tochal b'truma. So therefore, she can't eat truma because maybe she's not married to the Kohen. And if she's a Ba Kohen, she can't eat truma because maybe she is married to Yisrael, the first guy. So therefore, lo tochal b'truma, and therefore she can't. She's not married to the second guy either. She's mekudeshet, ve'ina mekudeshet, v'safek. Okay, we'll stop here and dedicate our learning to the memory of my father. Have a good day.